Today, I wish to consider one theory concept for a chapter of retirement or death of a partner. The theory concept that I want to discuss is about share in profit of the retiring partner from the date of last accounting year to the date of retirement. This is the point that I want to consider in theory. Now, partner retires when? At any time. Partner can retire at any point of time in between 2 year ending dates. Partner can retire during the accounting period. Suppose that my accounting year ends on 31st of December and partner retires on 30th April. So he has retired after 4 months from the last end of the accounting period. So partner is entitled to have a share in profit for these 4 months. How to find out this 4 months profit and how to grant a share to a retiring partner in this profit? This is a point of consideration in this theory lecture. Understand one thing. Partner retires in between 2 accounting year ending date. He is retiring during the accounting period. Now we want to find out the share of retiring partner in the profit till the date of his retirement, and that day for which period? From the last accounting year till the date of retirement. This is what we want to consider. Look at the screen. For this, either profit and loss account till the date of retirement is prepared. Suppose that partner retires on 30th April 2011, then you have to prepare a trading profit and loss account right from 1st of January 2011 to 30th April 2011. So prepare trading and profit and loss account for 4 months, find out the profit, give a share in profit to a retiring partner. This is the most reasonable way of giving the profit. But it is not feasible or practicable to prepare trading and profit and loss account for 4 months. In such situation, the another option that for this profit and loss account at the end of the accounting year is prepared. So we are preparing the profit and loss account for the year ended on 31st of December 2011. Profit and loss account at the end of the accounting year is prepared, dividing expenses and income between pre-retirement and post-retirement period on appropriate basis, and the profit is found. So another way to prepare the profit and loss account for the year ended on 31st of December 2011 as per my illustration. Then whatever the expenses that you debit to profit and loss account, bifurcate those expenses in the expenses for pre-retirement period, expenses for post-retirement period, and that bifurcation has to be done on any appropriate basis. Time-based expenses will be distributed in proportion of time. Sales-based expenses will be distributed in proportion of sales. Similarly, other expenses will be considered for bifurcation on an appropriate basis. Pre-retirement profit is distributed amongst all partners in the old ratio, and the post-retirement profit is distributed between continuing partners in the new ratio after retirement. This is the second option. Now, third thing, that instead of preparing profit and loss account till the date of retirement, or preparing profit and loss account at the end of the accounting period by bifurcating the profit and loss account details in pre- and post-retirement period, the third option, by agreement, profit for the same period is estimated. So in our illustration, partner retires on 30th April, 4 months have passed, make an estimate of profit for 4 months by agreement. But that estimation has to be made by the mutual agreement between the partners. So by agreement, profit for the same period is estimated. Now for the purpose of estimation, you are required to take certain criteria. So the by agreement profit for the same period is estimated. The criteria taken, that past profit may be taken as the basis, as the base for estimation, under a presumption that profit occurs evenly and is time based. So in this estimation method, what is the first presumption? Profit occurs evenly and it is time based. First presumption. Now second presumption, profit for the current year will be at par with profit for the previous period. On the basis of this assumption, estimation of profit for 4 months is done and share of retiring partner is given on the basis of this estimation. The second criteria or second, the another presumption for estimation may be taken. Another presumption can be profit proportion to sale is same in the current period as it was in past. So what's the second presumption? The first presumption, profit is time based. What's the second presumption? Profit proportion with sale is uniform in the current year as it was there in the previous period. So profit proportion to sale is presumed to be same and is considered as a criteria for estimation. The third thing, one another presumption can be that the rate of return on capital is same in the current period as it was in past. So rate of return on capital is identical in the current period as that was there in past. So these are the three presumptions on the basis of profit estimate is made. And in the estimated profit, find out the share of retiring partner, and you are supposed to write down the journal entry for that. The share of retiring partner in estimated profit to the date of retirement is debited to profit and loss suspense account and credited to retiring partner's capital account. So the journal entry for giving share to a retiring partner till the date of retirement, the journal entry for that profit and loss suspense account debit to retiring partner's capital account. But suppose if there is a loss, the entry is reversed. Reverse entry is passed in case of estimated loss till the date of retirement. What is the reverse entry? Retiring partner's capital account debit to profit and loss suspense account credit. This is how the journal entry gets recorded. Now, after explaining this theory concept, let me take illustration wherein estimation is done on the basis of presumption that profit is time based. Then I will take another illustration wherein I'll presume that proportion of profit to sales is identical in the current period as it was there in the previous period. And the third presumption, I am going to take these three illustrations on the basis of these three presumptions. Just observe on the screen. I want to take the illustration for this. Look at the A, B and C, who are equal partners. C retires on 31st of March 2009. The profit for the year ended on 31st of December 2008 was worth at 20,000. As per the agreement, retiring partner is entitled to receive his share of profit from the date of preparing last final accounts till the date of retirement. On the basis of last year's profit, C's share in profit will be calculated as follows. Now see, accounting year ends on 31st of December. Partner retires on 31st of March. So after 3 months from the date of year end, partner is retiring. So we are required to estimate the profit for 3 months. There is an agreement between the partners for the purpose of estimation of profit. See how the working, how it's worked out. Profit for the past year is 1,20,000. This is a profit. 1,20,000 is a profit for 12 months. Now I want to find out the estimated profit for 3 months on a presumption that profit in the current period is at the same level as it was in the previous period and the profit occurrence is time based. So 12 months profit is 1,20,000. How much is the profit for 3 months? Which are the 3 months I have estimated? From January 2009 to March 2009. These are the 3 months for which I am making an estimate. So 120,000 divided by 12 into 3. So 30,000 is the estimated profit for first 3 months of 2009. Now what is the share of C in this 30,000? Share of C, equal partners. So share of C is 1/3. So 30,000 into 1/3, 10,000 is the C share in the profit. What is the journal entry for that? Journal entry for that is profit and loss expense account debit 10,000 to C's capital account credit 10,000. This is how the journal entry gets recorded. Now this is an illustration given for this estimation criteria. Now I want to go for the second estimation criteria and let me take illustration there against. Now another presumption can be profit proportion to sale is same. So in the current period, profit proportion to sale is same. Look at this illustration. A, B, C who are equal partners. C retires on 31st October 2009. Sales of previous year is 10 lakhs and the profit is 3 lakhs. So proportion of profit to sales in the previous year will be worked out and that proportion will be applied to the sales till the date of retirement. The sales for the period between the last financial accounts and the date of retirement is 3 lakhs. C share in profit will be calculated as follows. Percentage of profit on sales for the previous period. So 3 lakhs divided by 10 lakhs into 100, it amounts to 30%. Estimated profit for the period till the date of retirement. What to do? This 30% ratio will be applied to the sales till the date of retirement. So sales till the date of retirement is 3 lakhs. 3 lakhs into 30%, 90,000 is the estimated profit up to 31st October 2009. Now I want to find out C's share in this profit. So 90,000 into 1/3, 30,000 is the share of C in this profit. What is the journal entry? Journal entry is profit and loss expense account debit 30,000 to C's capital account credit 30,000. This is how this presumption and the illustration therefore is explained. Now I want to go for the third presumption. Another assumption can be that the rate of return on capital is same in the current period as it was in past. Now look at the illustration where working is done under this presumption. Z retires on 1/8/2008. His capital for the year 2007 was 2 lakhs. The net profit of 30,000 earned by Z in the same year. So in 2007, Z earned a profit of 30,000 against his capital investment of 2 lakhs. Now whatever the profit is he earned, he has withdrawn it. So his capital balance remains same for the current year. $30,000 is earned by Z in the same year had been withdrawn by him. Determine Z share in profit for the year 2008 till the date of retirement on the basis of rate on return on capital. Now I want to estimate the profit for a period till the date of retirement, that is 1/8/2008. So from last balance sheet to 1/8/2008, number of months are 7 months. So I am required to estimate the profit for 7 months. Z retires on 1/8/2008. Z was a partner from 1/1/2008 to 31st of July 2007. So 7 months profit is to be estimated. His rate on return on capital for the previous period was net profit earned by him 30,000 divided by his capital balance 2 lakhs into 100, 15%. He has earned 15%. So now what will be his rate of return at the rate of 15% in the current period for 7 months? Then we want to work out. So share of Z in profit is 2 lakhs into 15% into 7 by 12. So his share in profit is 17,500. So 17,500 is the share of Z in profit till the date of retirement. The journal entry for that is profit and loss expense account debit to Z's capital account credit. This is how the calculation is presented here before you for this third presumption. This is the style of journal entry that I have explained to you. I think you have followed this concept really well. Thanks to all of you.